Yo, what is goody, everybody? It is your boy OG10. Welcome back to another video, and today we got ourselves a reaction video. Today we're going to be checking out the 2021 Landyachtz lineup of boards, because I know you guys like Landyachtz. I like Landyachtz, but honestly, I have not really looked at any of their new boards this year. The only one I know about is that the Turbo King, which is this guy right here, now has a new model called the Turbo Flight, because a lot of people have been commenting that for me. But besides that thing right here, I know nothing about it. Anyways, we're gonna get into the video right now. I'm not gonna try to pause it too much because it's already a 13 minute long video. So we're gonna kind of just keep it rolling. I'll try to, you know, give my thoughts and stuff while it's going. Without any further ado though, let's get into the video.
Well, here we are. Another year, another lineup from Landyachtz.
Yes, sir.
Quite a lot has happened since the last release, and we're stoked to show you guys what's on the menu for 2021. As always, we strive to bring you the best possible setup through our rigorous research and development.
Yo, I love this guy. This guy on Landyachtz is great. Like, you would not expect him to be this kind of a guy. He just hits these huge, crazy slides and stuff. It's so good.
Let's check out the 2021 Landyachtz lineup.
Like the editing,
wow.
Okay.
There is a lot of boards this year.
To make it easier to find the perfect setup, we've organized the boards into a few
Yo,
different
categories.
Yo, they
got street boards, okay. I don't know anything about those.
Longboard, right. ATV, dance, downhill free ride, surf skate, and race.
Surf skate and ATV I need to get into.
The biggest category this year, which is cruiser boards.
Yes, sir. You all love your cruiser boards.
Consists of compact boards, like everybody's favorite, the dinghy. Cruisers are perfect for heading to
That's
the store,
you.
Commuting to school, fleeing from zombies, hitting a mellow hill, and doing some carves, and even busting some tricks.
Yo,
Let's
I cannot do dinghy
classic.
Tricks. Those are
One
so
of our
hard.
Most popular boards due to its small size and versatility.
Yo, I'm telling
we
you.
We have this
those heavy wheels on my Turbo
King. Viscous dinghy. I like this graphic because it's
Make
kind
it
of
tough.
Like a window into another world. And you've got this matte blue, and behind that, you can see the wood grains poking
I'm
out
take
behind
mine out
the flowers.
Right here.
And you've got this embossed graphic with a nice texture to it. It's a beautiful setup right here. Here we have the dinghy dump truck. This board features wheel flares and 72 millimeter plow kings, which are bigger than most wheels that come on the dinghy. The graphic is done by Wolf Knight, and it features
Yo, so this
the
is
kind of
like this one. It's got the same wheels.
Truck. She's wearing a loose tooth t-shirt, which is a band that features Team Rider, Bryson Striker Lions,
okay.
And our videographer,
It's
Dave.
Probably like the Turbo King, man.
Another dinghy featuring the plow kings is the Mischief. This is just a really fun
really?
Graphic for a really fun board.
Okay, so these are probably like mine, except it doesn't have That's the fiberglass in it. So it might be cheaper that way.
Thanks.
Interesting.
The dinghy blunt is just a little bit larger than the classic and a little bit smaller than the tugboat. It's kind of like the perfect compromise between the two if you can't decide.
And Yo, if you can't afford the Turbo King dinghy
with 130 millimeter
polar bears. The dinghy blunt, man.
Next up, we have the paper tiger blunt. This paper tiger blunt features a paper tiger.
Ooh.
It's the same artist
as
our dugout surf skeleton.
Yo. Their new graphics this year are sick, I'm not gonna lie. Those are pretty sick. That one's alright, I guess.
Birds! Check out the new dinghy turbo. We added way more birds.
That's the new turbo?
The more birds, the better. That's what I
always
say.
Not my favorite, but definitely improvement over last year. Last year it was just all black.
He loves birds!
So I'll take it.
You guys are gonna flip out when you see the new tugboat graphic, Flippy. We've also brought back a ton of your favorite graphics from last year.
Mm.
We just couldn't say goodbye to these classic graphics quite yet.
All right.
Oh, time for the ATV category. The ATV category is where you're gonna find the traditional skateboard shape, and there's also some funky designs. These boards can be used in a wide variety of skating styles and many different environments. Completes come with polar bear, TKD
Yo, I'm not
trucks,
gonna lie.
And soft durometer wheels.
I kinda want an ATV.
Makes things like cracks and rocks a lot less of an issue. Be on lookout for boards marked
Once
as
I get
ATVs.
My new dancing board.
This features two composite layers inside the board, giving you an extra pop and helping the board stay stiff for longer. Boop, boo, loo, doo, doo.
Howdy, Alex.
Oh, what are you doing here, Howdy Horse? I thought you were supposed to be on the ATV Classic.
What is this?
Oh, right. Sorry about that. Here we go.
That's better. Check out this ATV Classic, available with this awesome horse graphic or the egg timer.
The Classic is just like a normal skateboard, right?
Solid street skate deck that's width is
8.5
inches.
Just with bigger, softer wheels than like a normal deck.
Perfecto is back with two fresh graphics. We stepped outside the box a little bit with the Wrestler, and I just love the colors.
That one reminds me of like,
both the Classic and
if you take the dingy shape, but you make it like a normal skateboard.
While we're on the subject of ATV, let's talk a little bit about the ditch life. Okay, sick, dude.
What?
I'm feeling this right now. Yeah, so the shape is basically a modern take on an old school design.
It looks like a tugboat, and they just took the tail and the nose and just went
so far. Oh,
that's kind
of
sick, I'm not gonna lie. I kind of want an ATV, guys. I might have to pick one up.
He's gonna be riding this bad boy.
I gotta get better at these skate tricks, man. All I've been doing is longboard stuff, which is cool.
ATV
Don't get me wrong.
Two new ATV shapes for 2021.
But like,
first is the Slim Jim.
I gotta get into this.
Yeah, it kind of almost has like a surfboard look to it. The back half of the board really tapers a lot, but front half kind of stays the same. Out of all the ATV series, the Stone God is the funkiest of them all.
For skaters.
It looks
what
wild,
is that?
But it feels good under your feet. Perfectly balanced board.
That's weird, but I can see it being good for slides. You know, you got the grooves,
back.
Hook your
and
feet in, kind of slide,
an
you know?
There's cat slide. On the board. It's about time we put a cat on the Rally Cat.
I see what you did there, okay. I gotta get better at sliding too, I'm not gonna lie. Street skating stuff and sliding, Those are gonna be some goals this summer to work on. Bro, what are you huh?
I guess it's time for the longboards. The longboard category.
You're doing too much, man. Stop.
Drop through and longer cruiser
boards. He's doing too much, guys.
These are perfect for people who want to cruise some mellow hills. Make some deep
so you're talking about the drop cat or just like in general?
Really enjoy the concrete.
I
kind of
want me a drop cat too. I want too many boards.
Let's start things off with the drop hammer.
The drop hammer.
This board is available in our two pine.
I've heard the drop hammer is like the drop cat, except a little stiffer.
This symmetrical longboard is easy to cruise around. It's fun to make some nice carves.
That was pretty clean.
And you can definitely throw some nice slides with the 78 millimeter Supreme Hawk. Okay, up next is one of my favorite boards of all time.
It's a little big for size.
This flexi drop-through longboard has been in the lineup for so many years for a reason. And that's because this board's a good
board. Okay, I know the Battle Axe is popular.
We have a fierce-looking tiger gracing the Battle Axe with its presence.
I don't know, man. It just don't seem appealing
new
to me.
New drop cat.
I'm just not a fan of that shape.
Huh? This ultra rockered longboard is available with two sizes, two graphics. I'm feeling the colors in the vibes graphic. We switched up the
dude, I want that graphic. That is sick.
Black look.
Okay,
now
ATV,
the Ripper and the Dipper.
Drop cat vibes graphic.
The words best board ever.
And new dancer board. Those are the boards I gotta get, guys. Holy,
this
I
year
want
we
that.
Have the Hawaiian matchbook-inspired postcard graphics,
okay,
which is a perfect match for these surfy Tom.
That kind of looks like an egg board, but if you just took the egg
we
board,
we know that technically the Ripper isn't a pintail, but it rides just the same as one, with the addition of a popping kicktail.
Ooh, okay. Guys, that is not easy to ollie on a board like that. Trust me, that's impressive. I'm not gonna lie. I do need a pintail too. Man, I need every
time to move on to our newest category that we introduced last year. Surf category.
Surf category. Okay, let's go, let's go.
This is for
I also need
that
a surf skate.
Like
lines
and want to just make some deep turns.
I actually want a surf skate.
This year
like,
we've narrowed our
they seem kind of cool.
Trucks from 155 millimeter.
They got weird trucks too.
130 millimeter.
Like look at those trucks, they're like
the
super
pivot
high.
Make them pump harder and turn.
Like, how do you not get wheel bite from that, right?
We've also changed our wheels this year. The new ones have a sharp lip, and they're nice and glossy to make those big bank slashes really grip.
Sharp lip,
all
sharp
of our surf skates now
yeah,
come
that's
with
make
soft
it
top grip tape for that extra cushion under your feet.
Oh, they have foam grip tape? That's
two wheelbase options.
That's weird.
Shorter for pumping and longer for cruising. To top it all off,
weird.
We've added a new shape called the Surf Life. It's available with two different
You wouldn't
graphics.
Want to be doing any pop Our tricks on something with foam grip tape, though.
It's really turning into one of the most fun categories.
That looks like a pretty sick skate park, I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little jealous, not gonna lie. These guys are located in Canada, right? They got some pretty sick stuff if that's where they're filming, or they might be in the LA branch of Landyachtz.
Let's pick
which
up
would
the
not
speed
surprise me.
And take this video downhill. The downhill free ride category.
All right.
These boards are
this is
people who want
this category I'm like
I want to shred some things.
I'm not as knowledgeable as I should be in the
We're
downhill
so
free ride.
Excited.
And you guys have been nagging me about that.
We are
I know.
So
I'm going to get into it, okay? We're going
to
learn a lot of slides and stuff. We're going to learn together
board
this summer.
It's called the Free Dive. This board has been
dive
in development for a few years now by our team riders, and we're pretty pumped to show it to you guys.
See, the thing is, I don't really know if I need
good, man.
A free
like
ride
a
deck
with maple and pre-cured fiberglass to give you that stiffness you want when you're riding fast. Features include,
like, as a beginner, I think I can just use the ones
wheel
I have.
Flares, multiple wheel
but these are kind of sick. They're not gonna lie, they're pretty cool.
Flush mount and deep concave. It's made at our Canadian factory in Kimberley, BC. The complete comes with 155 millimeter Gen 6 Grizzlies.
I don't know how I feel about that graphic. It's cool,
the
I guess. It's alright, but I don't know if I get
hanger,
it.
Give it the right amount of lean. It also comes with the 70 millimeter Supremes, which have become a favorite amongst our team riders that love free riding.
Do free riders use 70 millimeter? I thought it was like 65. I mean, I guess 70, but I feel like 65 would be better.
The Switchblade and the Evo are both back, and we kept the graphics the same because we love them. One thing we changed on the Evo is it now comes with 40 degrees.
We kept the graphics the same because we love them. Come on, guys. Come on, guys. You know the only reason you did that was because you were too lazy to make new ones. Come on. Why are you putting them in the new lineup if they're the same graphic and, like, the same board? You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever.
Three Gen 6 155 millimeter trucks. The back end is now extra stable, and the front gives you even more lean. The faster you go, the better it feels. Our race category is still going strong with our three rider design boards. Dexter Manning's small blind, Kyle Martin's obsidian,
racing is
El Peligro.
Too fast for me right now. Too fast.
Throw in some cheetah hogs and some bear smokies, and you've got yourself a ticket to the podium.
And they make
the
racing board small,
perform
so
at
like,
the races.
Bro, you're going like 70 miles an hour down a hill on something like this, bro. On something like
time
this,
for our
bro.
Final category.
I don't know, man.
This happens to be one of our most fun
I don't
categories.
Know, man.
Dance.
Hey, let's go. The dance category
the
is
dance
the best
category.
Category
features boards that are meant for stylish tricks
holy
and freestyle maneuvers.
Yo, this is what I'm.
They're also great for people that just want more space for their feet on the board.
This is what
this
I'm
year,
talking about, guys.
This year, our smaller
dancing
dance
boards
board, the Tony Danza, is available in two different graphics. This board features twin kicks, comfy concave.
Okay,
snappy
so they're making a smaller dancing board this year.
Board
okay.
For somebody that wants a lighter, smaller dance board to bust a move.
That's kind of how I view my dancing boards. I like the smaller ones.
We also have our classic Stratus 46 with two different graphics in all wood construction and also available in our amazing Holotech. The Spectrum graphic looks absolutely incredible.
I don't know how I feel about those tails.
And the fiberglass layer gives you a nice flex.
I do like the grip tape and
the
graphic though. It's a good touch.
All the boards in this category have grip tape on the nose and tail with no grip in the middle. And this gives your feet the perfect depth.
I don't know about that concave though. It doesn't look super super concave on the sides of the board. Could be problematic for me. I really like my dancing boards to have a really sharp concave on the sides.
Landyachtz lineup. Putting this line of boards together was no easy task.
Okay.
We hope you feel proud when you're riding our boards.
All right, we're gonna stop the video there because that's pretty much it. So, final thoughts. I think they got a pretty solid lineup, not gonna lie. I really like how, you know, especially for this particular dinghy, the Turbo King, because this is the one that I personally have experience with. I really like how they went from, you know, just a completely black board to putting some bird patterns on it, you know. I feel like they could have done a little more personally, but, you know, it's a nice touch compared to literally having nothing. I like that. I like how they have a new dancing board that's smaller size because that's kind of what I really like in dancing boards. The really long ones are cool, and I do want to get one, but I like the smaller ones because, you know, a lot of my freestyle stuff is a lot of popping involved with the board and hand flips and stuff. It's just easier to do that with a smaller dancing deck, personally. So I think that's cool that they included that. I really am interested in the ATV stuff, I'm not gonna lie, because I need to get into skateboarding more with just, you know, some classic skateboarding tricks, you know, because I've just been focused on longboarding for a lot, so I gotta, you know, kind of branch out a little bit more into the skateboarding stuff because I haven't really practiced a lot. I think an ATV would be cool for that because I don't like just being limited to skate parks and really smooth ground. So getting an ATV where I can take it on rougher areas and not have to worry so much about it is really appealing to me. So I really want to check those out this summer, hopefully. And the surf skates. Surf skates are, I don't know, they seem cool because I'm pretty good at pumping, right? And surf skates are like, they're made to be pumped. So I kind of want to check one of those out too. You know, just honestly, just to test it, you know, let you guys know, is it something you should even consider? Because they're kind of like a niche board kind of product. So we got to test it out a little bit. So that's kind of what I'm hyped about. I like the new dinghies. I like the new dancers. I like their boards. I don't like how some of the boards, they said they just kept the same graphic. It seemed a little lazy to me. Not super into the whole free downhill racing, but if you guys really want me to learn sliding with you guys, we can experiment a little bit with that. Anyways, this video is getting kind of long. I don't want to drag it out too long. Hopefully you enjoyed the video hopefully you enjoyed my reaction to the video, I guess. Yeah, I thought it was a good video. Anyways, that's all I'm going to be talking about today. Hope you guys liked the video. I make videos every Wednesday and Saturday, so you already know what's going on. Check out the new videos coming in the future. Check out previous videos. If you like this one, hit the sub button for me. That's all I got. I'm out. Peace out, guys.